IDEATE is the annual panel discussion hosted by the Bansidhara Neela Panda Foundation, and we bring in experts from various sectors to discuss ways forward and to create awareness on pressing social issues.
We had a panel discussion on the role of Mahila Arogya Samitis in community participation and community mobilization to ensure the outcomes of improving a holistic health care for urban poor.
काफी सारे बड़े-बड़े लोगों ने आकर अपना अपनी राय प्रकट की अर्बन हेल्थ केयर के ऊपर.
The most important aspects in urban health, I think there are two sides of the coin. One is preventive or health promotion, and then curative services. I think both are equally important.
Very few organizations take a pause and ideate. बहुत ही कम संस्थाएं हैं जो कि आत्मचिंतन करती हैं कि हमें क्या करना चाहिए. It is rarest of the rare organization which I have seen in my career to really think, pause, and each year ideate with the community of practitioners. So I really congratulate you.
The whole program, it was glorified and value added in the presence of the lady, sister, Sarojini, because they are from the ground level.
आमे समिति आरोग्य समिति महिला आरोग्य समिति माध्यम रे चेष्टा कर अंधविश्वास दूर करिया पई आउ ए झडाकुंबा नकरी से माने मेडिकल ट्रीटमेंट हेबे.
आई बिलीव अर्बनाइजेशन इज अ डबल एज सोर्ड. ऑन वन हैंड इट गिव्स पीपल द अपॉर्चुनिटी फॉर ग्रोथ एंड ऑन द अदर इट लीड्स टू राइज ऑफ अनप्लान्ड ड्वेलिंग्स एंड इट एक्सपोजेस द पीपल and the communities of those dwellings to many challenges, especially one of health. According to the 2011 census, almost 65.5 million Indians live in urban slums. The overcrowding in these slums results in unhygienic conditions from substandard dwellings with insufficient and poor water supply. India accounts for over half of the estimated 100 million people pushed into poverty worldwide every year due to out-of-pocket expenses on healthcare. That high cost of treatment ails India's health sector, and patients avoid health services even when needed. Both Government of India and Government of Odisha have launched a series of schemes for the urban poor through implementation of Urban Healthcare Mission, the Atal Mission for Urban Rejuvenation and Transformation, Housing for All, Biju Swastha Kalyan Yojana, Nirmaya, etc. In this regard, it is Odisha that has pioneered an urban healthcare program, the Mahila Arogya Samiti, popularly known as MAS. It is a women-centric healthcare structure which brings through convergence the frontline care personnel, the urban development body, and most importantly, the residents of the targeted locality together. This program was piloted under the Health of Urban Poor project in Odisha during 2010-15, and subsequently taken up by Urban Health Mission of Government of India. Under the Urban Health Mission, till date, Odisha has been able to form more than 3,000 functional Mahila Arogya Samitis across 36 urban areas. It is without doubt that such a progressive program could lead the way for scaling the number of MAS not just in Odisha, but across India, and more such participatory programs can be inspired from this learning.
The urbanization in Bhubaneswar happens when the Bhubaneswar Development Authority acquires the land from the rural area. So they declare it is a urban boundary, the new urban boundary. Now, after the acquisition, that area, that geography is neither rural nor urban. Earlier it was rural, so you have a sub-health center, you had the PHC, you have everything. But the moment the Development Authority acquired that land, then it becomes just the kind of an upcoming city area on this. And municipality boundary, they reach there after 10 or 15 years time. So till then, lot of developmental activity happen, but they are neither rural nor urban, and that's how peri-urban they were known as, and they are the most vulnerable locality, and we have to keep in mind on that.
Corporate hospitals ho ya BHFI jaise organizations ho aur kafi sare aise organizations inme agar ek platform bana karke agar we come with our experience, they come with their issues, if we are able to come to a conclusion, and that's the way it should be, on packages which are extremely cost effective, and there is a willful participation from all parties, and I'm sure these Ayushman Bharat or the RSBI schemes can easily be implemented.
Low cost healthcare, right? I think it is not only for a private sector hospital to say we should create low cost healthcare infrastructure. They can even participate in saying, let us train more ladies at the local and the whether it's an ASHA, ANM, any frontline worker or anyone else who can even be brought into the fray, because we need to expand the number of frontline workers we have.
The urban sector has been disadvantaged for a long time. Very strong political leadership is required. So the governance, overall governance is absolutely important to keep in mind while we are planning urban health. In urban health, the community participation is extremely important.
गोटे टीका विषय रे गोटे मा जो मीटिंग आसीला से सात घर को कन्विंस करै पर जदा दायित्व जो सात आठ घर रहिला गोटे संपूर्ण टीकाकरण केमिति होबो गोटे पिला आसुनी ताको बुझे केमिति आनिबा से भी निजे संपूर्ण टीकाकरण विषय भी से माने जा अवगत हेगलानी ता सहित जदि स्वास्थ्य बीमा कार्ड लोक बसिक भी मृत्यु मुखर पड़ुले से माने जानी राष्ट्रीय स्वास्थ्य बीमा योजन लोक धरिकी बसिक भी लोक मृत्यु मुखर पड़ुले ठीक है ट्रीटमेंट हो पार नी से मासिक बैठक जो महिला आरोग्य समिति आलोचना कराए से भी आम आलोचना हुए एमती आम राष्ट्रीय स्वास्थ्य बीमा योजना द्वारा आम एति बेनिफिट अच्छी लोक मागणार अपरेसन हस्पिटा आसपार सब प्रकार आम आलोचना होम जो जनक मीट गला सी आसी आठ घर लोक कन्विन्स कर दायित्व आम निजे ही कर
One works with the community health workers, one has realized that one gives them enough skills or trainings to sort of take their job forward. What probably we have not done well enough is to identify and understand from their perspective what would they want as a provider, as a frontline worker provider. And the range of issues that there are there which one needs to solve for would be probably from as simple as timely remuneration to as complex as motivation.
How the service delivery system will be strengthened and reach the most appropriate and needy.
Kis tarah se ye ghetto mentality ko hum bahar laake unke andar health hygiene ko usme implant kiya jaye.
हम एक ही प्रोग्राम के अंदर उसको आइसोलेट नहीं कर सकते. हम अगर प्रोग्राम कर रहे हैं विमेंस एम्पावरमेंट के बारे में तो वो कैसे एम्पावर होंगे अगर हम उन्हें हाइजीन के बारे में बताएंगे, अगर हम उन्हें सैनिटेशन के बारे में बताएंगे. दूसरे तरीके से आप देखे जाए तो सही कह रहे हैं. और हमारे पिछले साल का प्रोग्राम स्पोर्ट्स फॉर डिवेलपमेंट था, आपको याद रहेगा. आप कोई कहीं भी चले जाए एजुकेशन का प्रोग्राम रखें तो उसमें स्पोर्ट्स तो आएगा, एंड स्पोर्ट्स इज अ वेरी इंपॉर्टेंट मीडियम फॉर हेल्थ ऑल्सो, टू कीप चिल्ड्रन फिट, नॉट ओनली टू टेक देम आउट ऑफ द स्लम बट टू कीप देम फिट. आर वी लिसनिंग टू द नीड्स ऑफ द पीपल एंड द बेनिफिशरीज इन द अर्लियर क्वेश्चन. कम से कम आई कैन आंसर दिस फ्रॉम अ फाउंडेशन परस्पेक्टिव. जब हम किसी एरिया में जाते हैं और हम एक प्रोग्राम करते हैं तो यस, स्टार्टिंग पॉइंट एक होना चाहिए. जैसे कि अभी हमने एक प्रोग्राम शुरू किया था जहाँ हमारा आइडिया था कि हम SHG के माध्यम से जाएंगे, लेकिन जब हम उस एरिया में गए तो हमें पता चला कि वहाँ पे डिमांड थी अडल्ट लिटरेसी की. तो हमने अपना पूरा प्रोग्राम इवॉल्व कर दिया, वी चेंज्ड इट बिकॉज दैट वॉज देन बिकमिंग अ नीड बेस्ड प्रोग्राम, एंड ऑटोमेटिकली द सर्वे वॉज डन ऑन द ग्राउंड that they first want द एजुकेशन पैरामीटर्स. तो आज हमने 3 सेंटर खोले हैं चोधवार में, जहाँ पे हम अडल्ट लिटरेसी सेंटर्स बनाए हैं हमने. लेकिन हम उसको सिर्फ अडल्ट लिटरेसी पे रिस्ट्रिक्ट नहीं करते, उसके अंदर भी हम लाइफ स्किल्स ट्रेनिंग, हाइजीन ट्रेनिंग, जैसे कि हमने महिला आरोग्य समिति में सुना. तो इट्स नॉट दैट वी डोंट हियर द फीडबैक, लेकिन एक प्रोग्राम का स्टार्टिंग पॉइंट होना चाहिए. मे बी जियोग्राफिकल एरिया इज वन वे टू लुक एट इट, एंड देन यू एड्रेस वट एवर नीड्स दे आस्क. इट इज़ इम्पेरेटिव टू रियलाइज दैट अर्बन हेल्थ केयर इज नॉट जस्ट एन इशू फॉर द स्लम ड्वेलर्स एंड द गवर्नमेंट. A wider group of stakeholders needs to take cognizance of the challenges and the prospects of urbanization, and they must start investing in avenues that will strengthen urban healthcare. Robust public-private partnerships can supplement the efforts in urban healthcare.